They say in English, when it rains, it pours. This saying, it seems to capture a specific situation or circumstance that, I don't know how best can I describe it, but it seems to tell us about a situation that comes on one's life, a very difficult one for that matter. In this case, let's talk about Sean Mkhize, a person who is said to be owing, she's said to be owing 37 million rand. Now, the way that has been phrased here is that it's called tax invasion. Now, according to SARS, they say, the South African Revenue Service, SARS, says it is making significant headway in its 37 million tax invasion case against controversial businesswoman Sean Mkhize. That's why I said, when it rains, it pours. We all know that. Did this person lose her life? I don't know. The person that was supposed to deal with the case of Sean Mkhize, that woman who got shot. I don't remember. I think if I remember vividly, she was hospitalized after sustaining multiple gun wounds, if I'm not mistaken. But I never got an update concerning her state. Is she still alive? Is she recovering? But today it's all about Mkhize. 37 million rand. Oh! But it's Mkhize at the end of the day. So she sells one of her mansion. She settles everything. At least that's what I assume. Right. Not even sure how expensive is a mansion. You're going to have to tell me in the comment section below. But how do you allow tax to get into that extent of 37 million rand? Well, she's got Royal AM, Royal Andelimpisan, as a football club. What if it gets sold? I don't know what is in my noise, guys. What if it gets sold as they are trying to get their money? That's the story that I want us to follow. The story that I'm reading here, it was written on the 29th of August 2024 by Umgezi Koko. Look at the heading of the article from Eyewitness. You say SARS is on its top of tax invasion investigation into Sean Mkhize. On Thursday, SARS Deputy Commissioner Jepsten Makubu joined several organizations picket outside the taxman's headquarters in Tshwane, held against the safety risk posed to whistleblowers. Okay, that is going to be quite interesting. The reason people are raising this issue of safety here, it is in connection to the person that got shot, and nothing more, nothing less. It's in connection to the person that got shot while she was on duty, still tracing or doing meetings with Sean Mkhize. But before we can even continue enjoying this episode and continue to dive deep into this episode, you need to do this. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge. And that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financial contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel. And you know what I'm saying? We'll bring you more. And also, guys, want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed. Okay, let's proceed from here. Let me read something here. It says on Thursday, I've already read that one. Let's proceed a bit. It says that here, the demonstration was sparked by a recent assassination attempt to SARS advocate Corret Now. Look at it's Naudi. I don't know. Naudi, who is representing SARS in Shonim Kizer's tax invasion case, was hospitalized in July after two unknown assailant opened fire on her outside a hotel parking lot in Umhlanga in KwaZulu-Natal. SARS immediately condemned the attacks and committed to working closely with police to root out the culprit. The Revenue Service also revealed that its workers will not be intimidated by criminals and that investigation into potential criminals are continuing. Investigation into potential criminal are. So in other words, I don't know if I'm reading it correctly. Are they saying that it could be that this person was sent by one of the person who we needed to investigate? That is what I'm hearing from this whole saga here. Then they said, SARS, I can confirm that the process is ongoing and we will continue to push it towards the end. It is nearing an end, Makhubu says. While the Hawks are investigating a case of attempted murder following the butchered hit on Node, SARS and civil organization believe the perpetrators will be brought to book. Makhubu highlighted the importance of protecting whistleblowers across various spheres of government. He said, or she said, I don't know, we are here to pursue a higher purpose. We are here to help the government to create a capable state that is able to meet needs of its citizens. Okay. Got okay. Like I said, that it. They said that. They say, when it rains, it pours. When it rains, something around that. Hey, Mam Kize has been now. Mam Kize Gota has been on the news sometimes for wrong reason, and yeah, man, I kind of felt like, hey, Mam Kize now, man, she needs to, at least, man, hey, man, she's been in the, yeah. But sometimes it's not for wrong reason, though. But some point, one day, I think, if I'm not mistaken, the other time it was about her, because I think she's into construction. So the other time it was about her and the construction, what that was happening. So, hey, I mean, I don't want to lie, Angsaz. You know, when it comes to mom kids, But now, I don't know. I answer as a maybe you do know one or two things. Please do let me know in the comment section below.